Welcome to 1111 Tarot. I'm Auntie D, and today I thought we would do our weekly angel message. So for those of you that are into numbers, I did see the number 9 three times together, so it was 999. I saw that grouping of three nines twice on the same page today, so I thought that was interesting. Thought I'd share that with you. Now, before we begin the read, just realize that this may not be your story. This may not be your read. It's very possible that you're functioning under a different part of your birth chart. However, you know your people, you know the circumstance, and it may very well be your story. So if it isn't, drop it at the door. I want to thank all the people that are sharing the videos. Like, we had exponential growth, and the word is getting around in a channel in the community. It's like cutting its baby teeth, and I'm doing that with you. And I want to say thank you. Thank you for allowing me to share my gift and be of service to you. I appreciate that so very much. I really, really do. I don't know. I felt drawn to these. I didn't think this was what we were going to start with, but we are. So let's go ahead. This is the Moonology deck, and it kind of tells us a little bit about the cycles that we go through when we're going through transition, which for me, I have a knowing of that we're always in transition. And sometimes we do metamorphosis, you know. But I feel when the wheel is always turning, it's just how slow is it going and when does it speed up? Lately, the wheel is flying. Whoa. Okay. Wow. I don't think we've ever had four of these. This is going to be a heck of a message. Okay, let's see. Because I don't, these are oracle cards, so I don't take them in reverse. But I do want to take them in order. Okay. Well, excellent. It says, the end of a tough cycle approaches, full moon in Capricorn. That's a sea goat there. So, interesting. So we all must be going through, the viewers here that are resonating with this, who we're talking to, has ended a tough cycle, or is ending. It approaches. It says, show the world the real you. That's full moon in Aquarius. Don't let your past hold you back. South node. And step out of your comfort zone. North node. Oh my golly. What? South node. Don't let your past hold you back. I felt hung up for a second too. Excuse me. And then step out of your comfort zone. Show the world the real you. You have south and north node balancing this out. Look, you've got it. Beautiful card. Interesting. I think we're going to read this north node and south node. How about that? We'll do the north node this time, and the extended, we'll read the south node and compare the two. All right. Wow. No, here. Okay. Here we go with this deck. Now, these are Celebration of Love, I believe is what they're called. Let me double check. I don't want to say the name wrong. By they're by Schiffer. Celebration of Love. Yay, they're a newer deck. They're very interesting cards. The backs of them are like pieces of art, like I could frame it. Beautiful cards. Nice and sturdy. Well-made cards. So you've got South and North Node. Now, what does that mean? Well, I'm not an astrologer, but I do have an understanding that this is part of your birth chart. So you can look up based on, if you know the time you were born, you can actually pinpoint where all the stars were when you were born, the moment you were born, the second you gasped out for air. where were the stars? Because your south and north node will be there. Now think of your south node, I believe, as your shadow work, and I believe your heavenly blessings are in your north node, and then I believe there's a middle line as well. I could be wrong. Don't quote me. Like I said, I am not an astrologer. I'm not a doctor. I am a seer. So I work intuitively. But I do feel, you know, obviously we have south and north. So it's polar opposites. And when you look at your polar opposites, you've got your south. Don't hold back. I feel that is something that you feel your past has brought you something that you don't want to let go of. Like you'll miss it. And that's what you're holding on to, a piece of memory that you keep replaying somehow. And then it says, step out of your comfort zone. That would be allowing that connection to that memory to not be as powerful. Okay, so that would be the end. That would be how you come to the end of the tough cycle. And I think it would be more in line with you than you realize to let go of this. What doesn't serve you for a higher good, okay? You're like, well, I know, but I like this so much. And I know it doesn't do me any good. And I know it's not good for me, but I'm still going to do it. I don't think you will get as much satisfaction out of it. I think you're going to get strength from the universe to numb that attraction intuitively. So let's see what the read actually has for you on this angel message. That was just a lot because it was four cards, and I want to make sure that we're looking at this. And you have two full moons, so things are being clearly shown to you. And you do have Capricorn and Aquarius in this mix. So it's really important that you find out who the real you is. Did you see that? That card flipped up, upside down, or face up, and shoved itself back in the deck. I just want to see. No others did. Okay. Highest potential. Door of eternity. Angel of choice. Door of eternity. Angel of choice. Okay. We're going to be reading this in the extended. Highest potential. Door of eternity. Angel choice. And this is our angel message. No, we're going to read this now. We're going to read this right now. Yeah. Just stop, because that is a very important message. I can feel that. So these were the celebration of love. And let's see, what page do we have for highest potential? 55. There's your number. 55. 55. Stay alive. Right? And here we go. Highest potential. This image celebrates the gift of free choice bestowed upon us by our divine creator. It calls us to evoke the guidance of our heavenly support system in order to make the best choices, which are in alignment with our highest potential, before we cross the threshold into the vast unknown. Choose to look for and focus on the good and the highest in all people, circumstances, and things. If there is a choice to be made in your life, look for all the options and see which one holds the highest resolve for you and all involved. If you cannot see it, create it. Now, you have a special message, which these do come with. It says you may be at a crossroads in your life. Stop right there. The end of a tough cycle approaches. Show the world the real you. There's your crossroads. So you may be at a crossroads in your life. You are being inspired to take the high road. This may not be the easiest and most convenient, but by choosing the path of integrity, it pays dividends in spiritual gold. Choose wisely. Talk about a beautiful angel message. So we stop right there. I mean, wow, that was incredible. So we do have this choice to make. And it's up to us which road we take, because we do have free will. But at the same time, what do we want in our life at this point? Do we want harmony and peace and satisfaction? And what do we want? That's the question. Okay, the outlaw with the hiking boot, heading off to the mountains, that kind of outlaw, like the nature seeker. I feel like somebody's approaching you. That you are not used to. And think about that high road they just talked about in this mountain, okay? The outlaw is a person to me. I feel like there is someone coming towards you that is spiritually awake. They may not be your type, and I think that's why we have Show the World the Real You. Full moon in Aquarius. Could be somebody from Aquarius. Let's get the rest of the story. Soul work. And bees have a hive. Like a soul hive. You know, a spirit hive, if you will. They work together very well. So this and soul. I feel like this person coming towards you is a soul mate that will work very well with you. Just like two busy bees. Trust and look at that mirrored. I feel this person will mirror you very well. Reclaim. When you look at reclaim, it's a dog, and it, you know, I think of loyalty. Reclaim. I think you have a soulmate coming in, and I'm not talking romantic here. I'm not talking anything. I don't know what it is yet. Could be. But this could be just a soul tie. This is somebody that's going to help you with the job that you have got in front of you. Soul work. This is a soul mate. They're not going to be the normal person. You may not even know them. No, I feel you do. You'll know them very well, but you might not know them from this lifetime. The minute you meet this person, if they're not from this current 3D past, the minute you meet this person, you will feel something physically curious about it. Like you feel like you've known them forever in a very short amount of time. Like they will mirror you in a lot of ways. This could be, I don't see this as a twin. I see this as a soul mate. Twins usually, from what people take away from twin flames, is that one gives, the other takes, da-da-da-da-da. No. This is more like the soulmate that's for once in a lifetime. And I don't know if it's romantic or not. I am not sure. All right, guys, let's go ahead and take out my little mobile deck. I played with this a little bit this weekend myself, doing my own reads, but it comes in handy when I want to lay some cards out to really understand. Like it says reclaim. So is it from this lifetime or from a previous life? And is this a soul mate? So right over soul work and reclaim, I would like to clarify the connection between the soul work and the reclaim. And by the way, these are Threads of Fate Tarot. Threads of Fate Tarot. Now, this little deck is just a little mobile deck, but it works for me really well. Soul work. Okay, we have cards that are not. Ooh. Very nice. And the deck is upright, so to get this in reverse is very good. So this is the Liar, Cheater, Thiefer card, and it's in reverse. Oh, reclaim. Someone stole this relationship. This is supposed to happen. This is fate, and somebody stole it. And it's being reclaimed, possibly in another life. Let's look at outlaw and trust. Can I get a definer between the outlaw and trust? I feel like somebody interfered and sabotage this relationship for a long time. Oh my gosh, the Outlaw with Trust is that big old Page of Cups. We have love. This is passion and love. Somebody stole something away. And it's being reclaimed. And think about it. Door of Eternity. Angel of Choice. Step out of your comfort zone. Show the world the real you. The end of a tough cycle approaches. Don't let your past hold you back. Oh. Don't let your past hold you back. Look what's crossing this. Taking back what's mine, reclaiming with this new cup of love. Ten of Cups. Absolute bliss. Everything your heart desires. Right there. I mean, seriously? That's exquisite read. Thank you for all the blessings the universe has given to us. This is incredible. Now I want to see what's pushing this forward. Oh, a new beginning, but there's still like that past. You've still got a little bit of a... You've got your magical, passionate past kind of behind you. Like, I'm not letting go of this magical passion I got. And I don't know if I can have it with you, but I want to. We got a whole storybook. Here we go. Quick little story. Temperance. You're going to think about that. You're feeling a little defensive. Maybe this is happening very quickly. That is, this Page of Cups is a tidal wave. It is going to sweep this child off her feet. And that could be happening to you, just sweeping you off your feet like you're light as a kid. I mean, it's coming in quick because it's wands and it's cups. And it's 10 cups. Like, you must have 9 cups already where you did your wish, because you're getting the last cup, which gives you the 10 of cups. Now, when you look at this spread, and we're going to get into the rest of your cards. I just don't want to go too fast here. You have the Outlaw and you have the Soul Work, right? Somebody you're not used to. When I say that, I mean not your normal kind of person. They think way outside of the box. They really do. You combine them with you and the Soul Work is very, very good together. Like that bee in that hiking boot. Let me look at this boot for a minute. Could see Pisces to me. I do see Pisces in this handle on this knife. I'm trying to get it so you can see it there. I see wheat sticking out the back of the boot. So this is somebody that I believe knows their worth. Like, they've gone through the thresher and they know what's good, you know? Definitely amazing cards. Beautiful angel blessings. I just want to keep these cards the way they're supposed to be. But I did want to share that with you. And let's put the rest of the deck out of our way for now. Because you still have this entire book. Okay, so Temperance. For the Empress, yes, this is divinely guided. The Empress is showing. Temperance for the Empress. Now let's go over here to this energy. A little defensive. Someone, it's magical. You can feel it. It's very passionate. But it's a challenge. For some reason, there's a challenge here. I feel like somebody, maybe both of you, are holding on to past pain a little bit. You're both being given strength, and there's that eight above. If you look, the female would be eaten by that lion. He'd be like, chicken dinner. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. But the divine's like, no. Beauty and the Beast comes together. I feel like this could be King of Wands is passion. Just intense passion. That worry of the past, I do feel that's what you were worried about. That's what you're defensive about, is do I feel passion with this? I mean, even though you don't want the old relationship, I think you still want the passion to be there. Like, in the intense way that you expect it to be. But you want to move into calmer waters. You got the Six of Swords. And that's over here with your Temperance and your Empress. Like, the Empress is just like, look at her. She's like, I'm going to think this over. I'm just going to sit here. And she's got wheat down here too. So I think she's been through it all. Or those might be, yeah, that's wheat. She's also got a shield. See, she's had to defend herself. Yep, overall energy for both of you from the past. You're ending the top cycle approaching, which is the ending of all this pain. I think that's the overall energy. And you've got the highest potential door of eternity, angel choice. So I don't really want to lay that up there. I feel like that comes down here below the defense. It explains why you're defensive. You've both been hurt. You've both been through a lot of the same thing. So this person over here, the Empress, with her Temperance and the Empress moving to calmer waters, is going to work on themselves with the divine, as they always should and would. And that's beautiful. This is what we want. So this person is staying very, very close to the divine, and they are asking to be moved to calmer waters. Now this energy over here, wants that new beginning faster than you think. But the divine's giving them strength. They'll be patient no matter what. It's Page of Wands. They're passionate. They're very passionate. I feel like only have eyes for you. Seriously. Let's see what else we got. So I want to understand. So the King and a Page. This is an offer. Huh. I just want to get a blessing. I think when we get into the extended, I want to know about this reclaiming. There's something here that has me stumped. I feel two energies. I've got wand, wand, wand. So when I think of wands, I think of fire, Aries, Sag, Leo. But I have a lot of Pisces energy. So I'm not sure. We're going to see. You may have two approaching you. And quickly. You might have someone that says they've changed from the past coming in to reclaim what they feel is theirs. But you have this new person. Okay, that's where the extended's going to go, because I can feel something's amiss here. It's the Seven of Swords. Even though it's in reverse and it stopped, I feel like somebody's going to tell you they've changed from the past, and that's don't let your past hold you back. Yeah, there's a breach. So we're definitely going to have to get an extended. We have two energies, not just yours. So three total. Somebody's coming back. And what do they want to come back? Why is the Seven of Swords in reverse? We're going to dig in. So breach. But you do have an amazing person at one of these two. We're going to have to figure out which one. One of these two is your outlaw that you don't expect and is a little out of your ordinary, and the other feels like they're coming back in. But I feel like you've known them both from a past life or even this life. Something is up here. All right, my lovelies, I want to thank you if this is where you leave me, and thank you for supporting the channel in all the different many ways. You can donate to the channel. You can get a private reading. You can hit the like bell. You can like and the bell. You can subscribe. You know all the stuff, but everything you're doing is helping. And a lot of people are actually sharing the videos, which is, I think, the biggest help, to be honest. So thank you so much for your time and sharing your energy with me. I appreciate everything that you guys do for our channel and for me. With that, much light. Oh, wait. Stop. If you are leaving me here, that is what I want to say to you. And I hope to see you again very soon in the future. But if you're heading down here to follow the extended down below, I will see you in just a few minutes. And we're going to dig into a lot more of this two energy thing. All right. We'll see you soon. Much light, much love, and namaste.